Prince Harry and Meghan Markle seem to forget that they were in the middle of a pandemic during a visit to a Harlem middle school on Friday where they were seen hugging children, many of whom who were unlikely to be vaccinated. The Sussexes arrived at Harlem's A123 Mahalia Jackson School where Meghan read to a group of students before they were photographed hugging dozens of young school children. The school teaches children from grade 3 through to grade 8, putting students between the ages of 8 and 13. However, the group the royal couple met with appeared to be younger than 12. The children and the couple were all seen wearing face masks, which have been mandatory in schools across the state since New York Governor Kathy Hochul re-implemented the mask mandate after she took office last month. The official order requires students, faculty and staff for all grade levels wear face masks in both public and private schools. The public safety measure comes at a time when children under the age of 12 have yet to get approval for a COVID-19 vaccine, and the new Delta variant makes up the majority of new cases. Masks are not required for students eating lunch outside or for those who participate in outdoor sports, but those who were meeting the Duke and Duchess all appeared to be wearing face coverings. It all got too much for some of the children, who were reduced to tears as they were embraced by the former working members of the royal family. New York City schools have in-person learning this year, although at least one school in Harlem has been forced to resume remote learning. P.S. 79 in East Harlem went all remote following the discovery of 19 COVID cases at the school. Mayor Bill de Blasio has been adamant on all school learning to be in person this year, but there are concerns. EGUE do not hesitate to intervene to stop the spread. We follow stringent guidance from health experts to prevent any further transmission by quarantining close contacts, closed classrooms, and if necessary, entire buildings, a Department of Education spokesperson explained earlier this week. We're focusing on right now, we need testing every week, not every other week, especially in the elementary schools, where children can't be vaccinated, because that's an early warning system to keep those children safe, UFT President Michael Mulgrew said to ABC7. Across the city's traditional public schools, 635 classrooms were fully closed and 527 were partially closed as of Friday, according to the tracker. There were 197 total cases of COVID-19 over the last week in New York City schools, consisting of 150 students and 47 staff. The Sussexes came to the school alongside New York City Schools Chancellor Maysa Porter late Friday morning, after leaving their luxury hotel in Manhattan in their fleet of gas-guzzling SUVs for day two of their three-day New York City tour. Meghan sported a $5,840 Loro Piana Casmer coat and matching $1,680 pants for her visit to the public school, which serves shelters for families without permanent homes. Her shoes are thought to be $665 Manolo Blahnik red sweat pointed toe pumps. She accessorized her look with around $387,000 worth of jewelry, including her $350,000 engagement ring, a $4,500 diamond ring from her first public engagement with Harry as his fiancée, Princess Diana's $23,000 Cartier Tank watch, a $6,900 Cartier Love bracelet, and a $3,000 Jennifer Meyer tennis bracelet. While there was no expense spared for Meghan's outfit for the visit, which designed to promote early literacy, data from NYC Department of Education reveals an estimated 95% of students at the public school fall on the economic need index. The index means they face financial hardship, based on temporary housing, eligibility for public assistance and census poverty rates. A total of 94% of students are also eligible for free meals, according to Public School Review. This compares to 51% of students across the state. The couple appeared to have worked up an appetite during the visit as they then headed onto local soul food joint Melba's for a bite to eat. The restaurant, founded by Harlem native Melba Wilson, ties in well with the Sussex Whistle Stop Tour promoting vaccine equity as it became a COVID-19 vaccine pop-up to try to boost take-up in the neighborhood. The couple had been spotted exiting the Carlyle Hotel on Manhattan's Upper East Side with their beefed-up security to embark on what is expected to be another day of mystery meetings and engagements around the Big Apple. The couple kicked off the first day of their tour Thursday rubbing shoulders with New York lawmakers and UN officials, as well as paying their respects to the victims of the September 11 terrorist attacks at Ground Zero. They also visited the office of the World Health Organization, WHO, where they held a meeting with Chelsea Clinton, health officials and other experts to discuss vaccine equity, ahead of their appearance at Saturday's Global Citizen Concert. On Thursday night, Harry, 37, was spotted in Bemelman's bar in the Carlyle Hotel chatting animatedly with the people at his table, with no sign of Meghan, 40, inside. They are staying at the Lavish Hotel, where top-tier rooms cost up to $8,800 a night, during what is their first major public appearance since they shocked the world by stepping back as senior working members of the royal family last January. Both Meghan and Harry opted for more casual looks for the visit to the school in Harlem Friday, compared to their business-like attire the day before. The prince, meanwhile, swapped his formal suits for beige chinos and a long-sleeved navy polo shirt for the school visit, was touted as a way to promote early literacy. The couple sported matching black face masks as they greeted children in the playground of the public school, who showed the couple a brightly colored mural they had made. Meghan then took to the stage at an outdoor reading event to read her children's book The Bench to a group of second-grade students. Harry sat cross-legged on a cushion on the ground with around 2 dozen 7-year-old LEDs as they listened to the Duchess read aloud from the book. "Wrote this when we just had our little boy, and he haven't read it to any other kids but you," she told the children. After reading the book, she then took questions from some of the students and asked them what special place they share with the important people in their lives. "It doesn't have to be a bench. It can be anywhere where you feel comfortable," she told them. The Bench, released in June, explores the special bond between father and son as seen through a mother's eyes. Meghan has previously said the book was inspired by a poem she wrote for Harry on his first Father's Day, 1 month after Archie was born. Illustrations throughout are inspired by the Sussex family, including their daughter Lilibet Diana, who was only born 4 days before its release and after the illustrations were drawn. Meghan donated copies of her book to the school and the students presented her with paper hearts of pink and white with drawings and messages as the Sussexes left the school. The couple also donated 2 garden boxes filled with vegetables and herbs to the school. Through their Archewell Foundation, in partnership with Procter & Gamble, they also stocked the school's pantry with personal health and hygiene supplies. They plan to donate a washer and dryer to the school as well so more children can have clean uniforms. Meanwhile, the students also gifted Meghan with some of their drawings which they had penned onto pink paper hearts. The Duchess looked through the drawings after her reading session. An anti-vax and anti-mask heckler stood outside the school shouting through a bullhorn during the visit from the couple. The school, supported in part by the youth and family non-profit Graham Wyndham, serves children in kindergarten through 8th grade. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle seem to forget that they were in the middle of a pandemic during a visit to a Harlem middle school on Friday where they were seen hugging children, many of whom who were unlikely to be vaccinated. The Sussexes arrived at Harlem's S123 Mahalia Jackson School where Meghan read to a group of students before they were photographed hugging dozens of young school children. The school teaches children from grade 3 through to grade 8, putting students between the ages of 8 and 13. However, the group the royal couple met with appeared to be younger than 12, the children and the couple were all seen wearing face masks, which have been mandatory in schools across the state since New York Governor Kathy Hochul re-implemented the mask mandate after she took office last month. The official order requires students, faculty and staff for all grade levels wear face masks in both public and private schools. The public safety measure comes at a time when children under the age of 12 have yet to get approval for a COVID-19 vaccine, and the new Delta variant makes up the majority of new cases. Masks are not required for students eating lunch outside or for those who participate in outdoor sports, but those who were meeting the Duke and Duchess all appear to be wearing face coverings. It all got too much for some of the children, who were reduced to tears as they were embraced by the former working members of the royal family. New York City schools have in-person learning this year, although at least one school in Harlem has been forced to resume remote learning. P.S. 79 in East Harlem went all remote following the discovery of 19 COVID cases at the school. Mayor Bill de Blasio has been adamant on all school learning to be in person this year, but there are concerns. EGUE do not hesitate to intervene to stop the spread. We follow stringent guidance from health experts to prevent any further transmission by quarantining close contacts, closed classrooms, and if necessary, entire buildings, a Department of Education spokesperson explained earlier this week. We're focusing on right now, we need testing every week, not every other week, especially in the elementary schools, where children can't be vaccinated, because that's an early warning system to keep those children safe, UFT President Michael Mulgrew said to ABC7. Across the city's traditional public schools, 635 classrooms were fully closed and 527 were partially closed as of Friday, according to the tracker. There were 197 total cases of COVID-19 over the last week in New York City schools, consisting of 150 students and 47 staff. The successes came to the school alongside New York City Schools Chancellor Mesa Porter late Friday morning, after leaving their luxury hotel in Manhattan in their fleet of gas-guzzling SUVs for day two of their three-day New York City tour. Megan sported a $5,840 Loro Piana Casmer coat and matching $1,680 pants for her visit to the public school, which serves shelters for families without permanent homes. Her shoes are thought to be $665 Manolo Blahnik red sweat pointed toe pumps. She accessorized her look with around $387,000 worth of jewelry, including her $350,000 engagement ring, a $4,500 diamond ring from her first public engagement with Harry as his fiancé, Princess Diana's $23,000 Cartier Tank watch, a $6,900 Cartier Love bracelet, and a $3,000 Jennifer Meyer tennis bracelet. While there was no expense spared for Meghan's outfit for the visit, which designed to promote early literacy, data from NYC Department of Education reveals an estimated 95% of students at the public school fall on the economic need index. The index means they face financial hardship, based on temporary housing, eligibility for public assistance and census poverty rates. A total of 94% of students are also eligible for free meals, according to Public School Review. This compares to 51% of students across the state. The couple appeared to have worked up an appetite during the visit as they then headed onto local soul food joint Melba's for a bite to eat. The restaurant, founded by Harlem native Melba Wilson, ties in well with the Sussex Whistle Stop Tour promoting vaccine equity as it became a COVID-19 vaccine pop-up to try to boost take-up in the neighborhood. The couple had been spotted exiting the Carlyle Hotel on Manhattan's Upper East Side with their beefed-up security to embark on what is expected to be another day of mystery meetings and engagements around the Big Apple. The couple kicked off the first day of their tour Thursday, rubbing shoulders with New York lawmakers and UN officials, as well as paying their respects to the victims of the September 11 terrorist attacks at Ground Zero. They also visited the office of the World Health Organization, WHO, where they held a meeting with Chelsea Clinton, health officials and other experts to discuss vaccine equity, ahead of their appearance at Saturday's Global Citizen concert. On Thursday night, Harry, 37, was spotted in Bemelman's bar in the Carlyle Hotel chatting animatedly with the people at his table, with no sign of Meghan, 40, inside. They are staying at the Lavish Hotel, where top-tier rooms cost up to $8,800 a night, during what is their first major public appearance since they shocked the world by stepping back as senior working members of the royal family last January. Both Meghan and Harry opted for more casual looks for the visit to the school in Harlem Friday, compared to their business-like attire the day before. The prince, meanwhile, swapped his formal suits for beige chinos and a long-sleeved navy polo shirt for the school visit, was touted as a way to promote early literacy. The couple sported matching black face masks as they greeted children in the playground of the public school, who showed the couple a brightly colored mural they had made. Meghan then took to the stage at an outdoor reading event to read her children's book The Bench to a group of second-grade students. Harry sat cross-legged on a cushion on the ground with around 2 dozen 7-year-old LEDs as they listened to the Duchess read aloud from the book. "Wrote this when we just had our little boy, and he haven't read it to any other kids but you," she told the children. After reading the book, she then took questions from some of the students and asked them what special place they share with the important people in their lives. "It doesn't have to be a bench. It can be anywhere where you feel comfortable," she told them. The Bench, released in June, explores the special bond between father and son as seen through a mother's eyes. Meghan has previously said the book was inspired by a poem she wrote for Harry on his first Father's Day, 1 month after Archie was born. Illustrations throughout are inspired by the Sussex family, including their daughter Lilibet Diana, who was only born 4 days before its release and after the illustrations were drawn. Meghan donated copies of her book to the school and the students presented her with paper hearts of pink and white with drawings and messages as the Sussexes left the school. The couple also donated 2 garden boxes filled with vegetables and herbs to the school. Through their Archewell Foundation, in partnership with Procter & Gamble, they also stocked the school's pantry with personal health and hygiene supplies. They plan to donate a washer and dryer to the school as well so more children can have clean uniforms. Meanwhile, the students also gifted Meghan with some of their drawings which they had penned onto pink paper hearts. The Duchess looked through the drawings after her reading session. An anti-vax and anti-mask heckler stood outside the school shouting through a bullhorn during the visit from the couple. The school, supported in part by the youth and family non-profit Graham Wyndham, serves children in kindergarten through 8th grade. Thank you.